If in Excel you have a whole bunch of email addresses and you want to be able to create a list so you can copy and paste it into your either Outlook or Gmail, there's a couple of things you can add to it and you can do it very quickly in Excel. So for example, here's my email addresses. There's quite a few of them. What I want to do though is it must look nice. It must have the person's first name, their surname, the employee number, and then still work as an email address. Email addresses work like this. Any other info is over here. Then you've got the less than and the bigger than sign, which surrounds the email address. In Excel, the quickest way is to use Flash Fill. So here, notice I've got my columns adjacent to it. So column D, column E. I type what I'd like to see. So in this case, I'm going to type Hamilton Burger space 26801. Less than sign and then the email address. So you only need to do this once. And the bigger than sign. So when I click on it, so you'll see that looks correct. And what's nice is built into Excel data, you'll see here there's an item called Flash Fill. When you click on it, it replicates what you've done. So it looks at what you typed versus what was adjacent to it and then replicates it. So here, you'll see it seems to have got it spot on. And once it's in this format, you normally can go copy, go to the two, and when I go Control V, you'll see it's on its separate lines. Let's just check if Excel has recognized it. So it seems to have been fine. This doesn't always work, however. So if you find when you copy it, it just becomes one long line, what you can do is I come back here. Normally it's because a separator is missing, so either comma or semicolon. You can see my machine uses a semicolon. So just at the end here, I'm going to put a semicolon. In this case, you'll see it's immediately recognized it. Sometimes it won't, so then you must just go data flash fill again. But now I can again copy these. Just going to delete those, and when I paste it, I achieve the same thing. And again, I can just check that it works. So, this is a really quick way to be able to add even more information into your email name than you normally would have.